In today's video, I'm sharing two powerful techniques you can use to add a shadow effect in Photoshop. I'll be adding the shadow to text in this video, but you can use the same techniques to apply a shadow to objects. We'll start by selecting the Photoshop Horizontal Type tool to create the text. Then in the toolbar, I can choose the color I want to use, which in this instance is red. I'll then click on the image where I want to add my text, and you can see a couple of highlighted words appear. Let's add the words shadow text to the image. We can then click the tick icon in the toolbar to apply the changes. You can see that this has created a new text layer in the layers window. Because this is a text layer, we can continue to adjust it with the controls in the properties window. Let's change the size of this text to 72 points. This first method of adding a shadow to the text is with the Photoshop layer styles. You can access these at the bottom of the Layers window by clicking the FX icon. This lists the different styles that you can apply to this layer. I'm going to select the Drop Shadow effect. As soon as I add that, you can see that the shadow appears behind the text and we see the Layer Styles dialog open. Let's run through some of the controls that you'll probably want to use. First, we have the color of the shadow. When I click the color swatch, it opens the color picker. We can then use this to change the color to anything we think might work. For this text, I'm just going to use a black shadow. Below this is the opacity slider, which controls the strength of the shadow. The higher the opacity, the darker and more obvious the shadow appears, and if we reduce the opacity, it makes the shadow lighter. Then we have the angle control, which is a circle with a line in it. If I click this and drag the line with my mouse, I can rotate the angle of the shadow. Then to the right of this is another option, which is to use global light. When we set this, it tells Photoshop to use the same shadow direction for all drop shadow effects in this image. If we don't have this checked, it allows us to set a different shadow direction for different layers, which could look odd. Further down the dialog, we have a distance slider, which creates the illusion of moving text away from the shadow. Then there's the spread slider, which is a little like applying a stroke effect around the shadow. You'll probably use a low value for that for most shadows. And then finally, we have the size slider, which softens the edge of the shadows. The higher you set this, the more blur is applied to the shadow. We can then apply the settings to the shadow by clicking the OK button. Now, looking at the Layers panel, we can see the effects listed below the layer. I only have the drop shadow effect at the moment, but I could add others and they would appear in this list. We then have an eye icon to the side of the effect which I can use to toggle the shadow off and on. There's then another eye icon next to the effects heading which will toggle all the layer effects off and on. As you've seen, this is an easy way to add a shadow effect to text. Let's clear this now and look at another. An easy way to remove the layer styles is by right-clicking on the effects heading and selecting the Clear Layer Style option from the pop-up menu. For the next example, I will show you how to manually create a shadow for the text. I'll start by duplicating my text, which I can do using the keyboard shortcut Command plus J. If you're using a Windows PC, that's Control and J. Our image now has two identical text layers, one covering the other. I'm going to select the lower of the two layers and use that to produce my shadow. I'll then change the shadow's color by clicking the color swatch in the properties window. This allows me to change the text to be black. You can't see it now because the top layer is covering it. If I hide that, you can see the black text. The next step can seem confusing if you haven't used smart objects before, but please stay with me. I'll first select the black text layer in the Layers window by clicking it. Then I can go to the Filter menu and choose the Convert for Smart Filters option. This converts the text layer to something called a Photoshop Smart Object. Now I can go to the Filter menu and under the Blur submenu, choose Gaussian Blur. This displays the Gaussian Blur filter dialog where I can control the blur level. I can then click the OK button to close that. Applying the Gaussian blur filter in Photoshop is a destructive edit, meaning we can't change the blur amount. But if you look at the layer, we can see that we have a Gaussian blur smart filter appearing below the layer. When I double click it, it reopens the Gaussian blur dialog and I can change the value. This is why we converted the layer to a smart object. Now, Let's move the shadow so that it appears more like the shadow we saw before. For that, I'm going to select the Move tool. This displays a box around the text, and if I use the arrow key on my keyboard, I can move the position of the shadow. This now looks like the drop shadow we applied earlier, but we can get more creative with the shadow. If I click the Edit menu and come down to the Transform option, I can choose to flip the selection vertically. If I move the shadow down, you can see that it looks more like a reflection. Let's return to the Edit menu and look at some of the Transform options again. This time, I'm going to select the Perspective option. Photoshop then displays a message saying that it will turn off the Smart Filter, but this is only temporary. If I click OK, you can see that the Gaussian Blur Smart Filter isn't applied. Having done that, I can click and drag the shadow to move it sideways, making it look like there's light coming from behind the text. I'll also use this opportunity to get the shadow into position so that it lines up with the text. When I'm happy with that, I can click the tick icon in the toolbar to apply the change. If the amount of the blur on the shadow is too large, we can open the Gaussian Blur dialog and adjust it. Finally, we can adjust the opacity of the smart object to control its transparency, making it look more like a shadow. But that's not the end of the adjustments we can use. If we go back into the Edit menu and check the Transform options, we'll see there's a Distort option. When I select that, it allows me to change the perspective of the shadow and the size. Earlier in the video, we said you could apply these techniques to text and objects. The second technique we looked at is probably the best for this, and if you want to see how that's done, watch this video next. Thanks for watching today, and I hope you've enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and please share this with other Photoshop users. I'll see you soon for another video.